Let's talk about troubleshooting. Working in a DAW or any new piece of anything can be really frustrating because you don't know how it all works yet and you're gonna run into issues that you don't know how to solve. There's a lot of information out there that's available to us to solve our own problems, and that's just the basis of troubleshooting. You're gonna run into something you don't understand, and what I want you to do is have the tools and the skill set to go to the internet, ask it the proper question, and get the answer that you need. It can also be really frustrating going through this process because sometimes you don't have the vocabulary or the words to even phrase the question that you want to ask. You know, to be honest, this is how I taught myself how to use the software, was through a lot of Googling and watching YouTube videos and interpolating language from things that I didn't understand. So I'm going to try to give you some shortcuts to get some good results and also just give you the tools in order to solve your own problems. Usually when we get to this point, you might already be pretty frustrated at whatever point you're at. It's not working, you want it to work, you were in a nice flow state and you have ceased to be in that place. So before you even get started, it's important to just take a deep breath, and I promise you the answer is out there. We just need to do the proper Google search. So let's say I have forgotten how to create an audio track inside of Ableton, right? So that one's pretty simple. I'll say create new audio track. All right, so if I just stopped there, I'm not going to get the result that I want, because even the suggestions here, it's saying in Avid and Audacity and Premiere, we're not working in those softwares, we're working in Ableton. So we need to type in the name of the software that we're using. Sometimes it really matters what version you're searching as well. This course is in Live 10, so I'm going to type in Live 10. If you're using a different version of the software, you might want to type in Live 9, Live 8, whatever it is that you're working on. And lastly, you're probably going to want to type in the name of the platform or the machine you're using. I'm on a Mac, you might be on a PC, so typing in Mac or PC can also help to refine the search as well. So this is probably enough for me. Create new audio track, Ableton Live 10. So I'm going to press Enter and see what we get. So there's going to be a lot of answers here, and some of them will be better than others. So some of these have dates on them. You can see this was created July 4th, 2017. Some of them will be much older. Some of them will be much more recent. So if you are given a date, go with something that's more recent. If it was made in 2012, it might not be relevant anymore. So you want to stick with things that are newer. You can click on videos here and go through videos. These will all have dates for you. So this one, for instance, 2013, this is probably not one that you want to be looking at. So secondly, knowing reputable sources and clicking on those links is going to be better than sort of mindlessly searching through the internet, because there's a lot of people that make these types of videos that are going to be not as helpful. So if something has come from Ableton itself, that's usually a really great resource. Point Blank or other schools, DubSpot, there's a lot of people making tutorial content. So if it's coming from a school, you can probably rely on that being accurate and reliable information. There's some pretty reputable blogs like Sound on Sound or Music Tech. I'd start there. And then, you know, if you have to keep searching, just go through, look at the videos, look at all the posts. But you want the fastest route from point A to point B. So getting the keyword search properly done is going to be the first step in getting to the right results. And then sifting through them and choosing the right link to click on is going to get your answer faster. So this is not just a DAW-centric thing. Being able to solve your own problems is just a life skill as well. And it's going to get you through this course faster. It's going to get you to your musical ideas faster. And really, you're in control of your access to all this information.